Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Arun Pandya. Today, I will share my experience of Pathak Repertory through my today's topic, that is exploring bedside application of concept of sphere of action of remedy proposed by Dr. Bober using Pathak Repertory. The objectives of today's presentations are to explore the concept of sphere action of remedy as proposed by Dr. Bober, to understand its application at bedside using Dr. Pathak's repertory. Let's understand the concept of sphere action from various stalwarts' point of view. Dr. Bonnierson sir has given 7 points to understand the evolution of symptom. These are quiz, personality, the individuality, quid, disease, its nature and peculiarity, ubi, seat of disease, quibus auxilus, accompanying symptom, pur, cause of disease, comato, modification, aggravation, amelioration, condo, that is time. Here we can understand how Dr. Bonnierson has appreciated the seat of disease or concept of sphere of action of. Dr. Bonnierson also has given concept of complete symptom. These are location, sensation, modalities and concomitant. Here also Dr. Bonnierson has given important to the tissue, organ and system. Now Dr. C.M. Bober. Dr. C.M. Bober was an eminent homeopath. He was a follower of Dr. Bonnierson's philosophy and his concept. He translated the repertory of antisoric by Dr. Bonnierson. He published his own repertory called Bober-Bonnierson Characteristic Repertory, improved the lacunas of the therapeutic pocketbook. He revived the Bonnierson concept with positive modification by adding time dimension, tissue affinities and pathological general, adding the general modalities in general section and particular modalities in particular section. Now Dr. L.D. Dhavale sir. Dr. L.D. Dhavale sir has given the philosophical understanding of Bober approach. He highlights the Bober approach through time, tissue affinities and pathological general. Dr. L.D. Dhavale sir also suggested that physicians should have knowledge of anatomy, physiology, pathophysiology and medicine to understand the potent rubric of Bober synoptic team. Now Dr. K.N. Kassas sir. Dr. K.N. Kassas sir tried to simplify the Bober concept and he has given systematic approach to the Bober concept. Under the time dimension, he has given time modalities, causation, concomitant, epoch, onset, duration and progress, pace. Under the tissue affinity, he has given tissue, organ, system, site, region to be appreciated at general level as the tendency of the whole organism. Under the pathological general, he has given particular aspect of pathological process, behavior and pattern of disease phenomenon, peculiarity of pathogenesis. Now Dr. Pathak. Dr. Pathak was known for his artistic prescription. He was a follower of Dr. Bober's concept and his philosophy. He mainly used Bober synoptic key in his practice. Even Pathak repertory and Pathak mantra medica is mainly based on Bober synoptic key with clinically verified addition of rubrics and remedy. The origin of Pathak repertory. Pathak repertory is mainly based on Bober synoptic key. And the arrangement of Pathak repertory is an alphabetical arrangement. And this idea is come from the supplementary reference table of Bober synoptic key. And Dr. Pathak himself mentioned this idea in preface of his Mantra Medica, where Dr. Pathak wrote that it is my belief that Bober wished to compile a concise repertory arranged in alphabetical order rather than a regional one. In the same way, a concise Mantra Medica in which all relevant symptoms pertaining to each remedy are given was a desirable. He has given clues his synoptic key for compiling such a book. With my poor intellect and limited knowledge of homeopathy, I have tried to fulfill his wish. Now the objective of making the repertory. Dr. Pathak always desired to make a repertory which is handy and anyone can easily refer the rubric. That's why he made alphabetical arrangement and all the rubrics are in alphabetical order. The remedies under the each rubrics are very less in number because Dr. Pathak added those remedies which are clinically verified or strong justification provided by authorities like Dr. Boker, Dr. Kent, Dr. Clark. The number of rubrics is 1971 and the remedy is 393. Approach to the case. Dr. Pathak always tried to find the peculiar symptom of the case. He gave great value to the positive factor, circumstances of origin, the modalities and concomitant. He has given less value to the mental symptom, particular symptom, unless they are very prominent or strange. He also give less importance to desire, aversion or thirst unless they are very marked. In short, Dr. Pathak gives importance to the positive modalities, aggravation of amelioration and concomitant. Dr. Pathak usually use Boker synoptic key, his own repertory, Kent repertory and Clark repertory. Generals and particular. Many general symptoms are coined from the particular symptom. This is the key approach of Boker concept. And this approach or this type of general rubric which we can see in Pathak repertory. I give you through example. Example 1, calculi formation in general. If patient comes with complaint of recurrent calculi formation or calculi formation in more than two organs, like in kidney or gallbladder or pancreas, at that time we can take this rubric as a calculi formation in general. Rubric 2, abscess or suppuration. If any patient comes to our clinic complain of recurrent abscess formation or tendency to suppuration, at that time we can take this rubric as a abscess or suppuration. Dr. Pathak always said that it is better to consider the drug covering the particular tissue, particular modalities, and also the drug covering the general sensation and general mobility. Importance of sphere of action. Pathak has given certain rubric that correspond to the specific organ and areas. I give you few examples. One, cornea, pancreas, heart, kidney, liver, and stomach. Here we can understand how Dr. Pathak appreciates the sphere of action or tissue affinity. And this concept is from Bonison to Boker, Boker to the LDWA, LDWA Kasar, and Pathak. Dr. Pathak had added various clinical rubrics from his own experience and from authentic clinical repertories like diagnosis, example bronchitis, pneumonia and mastitis. Now I demonstrate four cases, out of which first case is case from Dr. Pathak sir's own clinic where he used Boker synoptic key repertory and the concept of tissue affinity. Patient presented with complaint of valvular heart disease with severe chest pain with palpitation, and pain was better by placing the hand over the precordium. The symptom considering for the classification was first heart, it is a physical particular location. Second, amelioration hands hold over the heart. It is a characteristic physical particular ameliorating modalities. Here we can see how Dr. Pathak appreciate the tissue affinities or location, that is a heart. The first rubric is heart and region of. Second, heart and region hand hold hand to. This is the ameliorating modalities. The case was repertorized with Boker synoptic key. The remedy coming was Natremoor and Lorax cirrhosus. The Lorax cirrhosus was prescribed and patient got relief. The concept applied was anatomical sphere, that is location and organ. Second is modality. Case 2. Case 2 is from my own clinic where I use Pathak repertory and the concept of sphere of action for tissue affinities. A known case of CA sigmoidocolon, patient presented with severe abdominal cramping pain since 1 month. Pain come every 10 minutes for 2 to 3 minutes with nausea, and pain is temporarily better by vomiting and ameliorating by injection diclofenac every 8 hours. And this whole complaint, the pain is aggravated after the operation. Oncosurgeon advised operation and diagnosed intestinal adhesion. if we go through the past history, the history of C. A. Sigmund Colon, patient was operated in 2014, followed by chemotherapy and radiotherapy. Again, recurrence happened in anorectal junction, and again operated and followed by chemotherapy and radiotherapy. After this operation, the patient the pain is started. Patient was thermally hot. The symptom concerning for the classification element from operation, it is a characteristic physical particular causative modalities. Second, adhesion, it is a characteristic physical pathological general fibrous tissue. It is a physical particular location. Case was repertorized with Pathak repertory, considering the rubric operation surgical after adhesion. It is a causative modalities. And second, fibrous tissue ligament, that is anatomical sphere. Please focus on the second rubric, that is fibrous tissue ligament. It is an anatomical sphere. Here we can understand how the anatomical sphere or tissue integrity is important for the totality, for final selection of the remedy. So, considering the rubric, and remedy was coming up silica and calcium flow. I took reference from the generality section of calcium flow from Pathak Matra Medica. Calcium flow mainly act on the veins and glands, produce the elasticity, and also act on glands, enlarge and become stony hard. It produces aneurysm, arteriosclerosis, fistula and cataract, and also remove the tendency to adhesion after suppuration. This is the exact symptom which we get from our patient. So, considering the Matra Medica reference and repertorization, also I differentiation with silica at tissue level and general disease level. At the tissue level, silica mainly act on the tubes, stachyon and tear duct, bones, whereas calcium flow mainly act on the veins and glands, produce the elasticity. On the generality and pathogenesis level, silica is very slow but incomplete process, then induration, then suppuration. But in the calcium flow, the slow process but complete and induration, and finally stony hardness. Considering the repertorization, Matra Medica reference, the final remedy was selected calcium flow 1 dose for a week. After 2 days of calcium flow, patient got 60% relief, and after 7 days, patient was free from pain. After 7 days, case was defined. The constitutional remedy was same, that is calcium flow. The concept applied was causative modalities, importance of anatomical sphere, that is location and organ. My learning. Importance of concept of sphere action proposed by Dr. Bogar in selection of simulimum, utility of corresponding rubric to organ, location of Pathak repertory, value to causation. Case 3, Master AP, 11 year male, patient presented with vomiting more than 5 to 6 per day since 7 days, vomiting content in gesta, vomiting suddenly, projectile without any prodrome symptom, that is nausea. The vomit is aggravated after eating and drinking. Pediatrician diagnosed query esophageal spasm, advised hospitalization. The symptom considering for the classification spasm, characteristic physical pathological general, vomiting nausea without, characteristic physical particular sensation, vomiting violent. It is a characteristic physical particular sensation. Because the considering the rubric, case repertorized with Pathak repertory, the rubric was considered is convulsion spasm, vomiting nausea without, and vomiting forcibly. The remedy was coming up veratrum viride and ginkgo. I took reference from the generality section of veratrum viride from Pathak Matra Medica. Veratrum viride mainly act on the medulla, stomach, heart, capillaries, and under the stomach section, we can see it mainly upon stomach produce the hiccup, painful, violent, constant with spasm of esophagus. This is the exact pathology which we get from our patient. And vomiting violent without nausea. This is the exact key negative symptom which we get from our patient. So considering the repertorization and the Matra Medica reference, I prescribe the remedy veratrum viride 201 dose and SOS for 1 dose. On the second day, vomiting was drastically reduced. From the fourth day, vomiting was completely stopped. The concept applied importance of anatomical sphere, pathological general, and key negative symptom. My learning, importance of role of Pathak Mantra Medica to understand the sphere action of remedy to find similarity. The specific symptom of the case is no nausea, which is a key negative symptom of case and covered by the remedy. Case 3, Ms. RK, 10-year girl, presented with swelling of left cervical lymph node since 5 days, mild pain, aggravation by touch with bluish appearance with solid consistency. Healing difficult, every injury suppurate. Surgeon diagnosed cervical lymphadenitis, advised surgery. Patient was thermally chilly. History of recurrent abscess 1 year back and operated for same. Symptom considering for classification, one is gland, it is a location physical common. Suppuration, characteristic physical general dispositional. Healing difficult, characteristic physical general dispositional. Bluish swelling, characteristic particular objective. The Pathak repertory use and symptom rubric considered for repertorization was glands in general, it is an anatomical sphere. Suppuration stubborn, it is a pathological general. Bluish purple, objective symptom. Here we can see how I have given importance to the anatomical sphere, that is the glands. I repertorized the case with Pathak repertory. Remedy was coming up silica and lachesis. I took reference from generality section of silica from Pathak Mantra Medica. Silica mainly act on the bones, glands, produce the exostasis, and on the gland it produce the enlargement. And the process is very slow, incomplete, and then finally induration and suppuration. So considering the repertorization and Mantra Medica reference, I prescribed the remedy silica 200 BD for 5 days. After the 7 days, patient was completely better. The concept applied was anatomical sphere, that is location, organ, pathological general. This was the follow-up. After the 7 days, patient was completely better from cervical lymphadenitis. My learning, understand the concept of organ affinity of Dr. Poker. Importance of reference of Pathak Mantra Medica help in selection of similimum. Importance of past history to find similimum. Now, advantages. Pathak repertory, the arrangement of all rubric in alphabetical order. It is the first and most advantage of this repertory. So any physician can easily refer all the rubrics from Pathak repertory. Second, the rubric correspond to the Indian foods, correspond to the generalization rubric, correspond to the general and particular modalities, pathological general rubrics, prophylactic rubrics, and the rubric correspond to the organs and areas, rubrics regarding ODP, mental and physical concomitant, rubric regarding key negative symptom, clinically verified remedies, and handy and quick reference, and diagnostic rubric. Whereas in limitation, repertory has a very less remedy, that is 393, less number of rubrics, that is 1971, as compared to the general repertories like Kent, like synthesis, like complete, like BBCR. Less mental symptom and his own clinical experience, no other source, difficult to practical use if philosophy is not given. Final learning and conclusion, Pathak's repertory is an ultimate tool which can be used at bedside where totality based on organ affinity. The utility of this tool can be best exploited when we are well versed with arrangement of rubrics and type of rubrics. To understand its application require knowledge of Poker philosophy and concept. These are the reference. So anyone want to work or evolve the Pathak's repertory, you can refer this reference. So finally, thank you so much. Thanks to MLMHI for giving me so beautiful opportunity and wonderful platform. Thank you so much. If you have any question, please mention in the comment section, or you can also write to me on drarunpandya980@gmail.com. This is my email ID.